Hi, Laura.
Hello, here we are.
Happy Wednesday to you.
That's the theme tune, we've got
at
it.
At last, Stephen Fothering has been saying we need a theme tune. There it is.
There we go.
It feels really strange because it feels as though we've been seeing each other every Wednesday. Mm. And yet the reality is very soon we are actually going to see each other, because this is the week that the church building is reopening for private prayer.
I know. And that feels really strange to see you in person again. And I guess that's probably what a lot of people are feeling, that we've seen our family, our friends, our loved ones virtually for, 12 weeks or something now? And now we're just beginning to see people in person again, which, as a raging extrovert, I just can't wait.
You do know that means, though, I won't be able to just wear pyjama bottoms and a vicar top.
I know, we're going to have to switch it up, aren't we?
It is a joke, of course. I am getting dressed every day. But one of the things that I just have been pondering, and we've just been kind of thinking about a bit, is, you know, how do we make sense of everything that's happened over the last 12 weeks? You know, we're coming back in, both literally to familiar spaces, whether it's church or work or the shops or whatever those familiar spaces are, we're coming back into them, and yet it's not going to be the same. But we're also coming back into a society that will be gathering again.
Yeah, and I think that can feel really huge and quite hard to process what on earth you can think about that. And I know for me that there's this sense inside of me that where I feel like things are becoming to look a bit more what I would consider normal again, familiar maybe, as you said, with huge changes, and not trying to ignore all the social changes and the cultural changes that have happened over the last lockdown period and few weeks as well. And I think for me personally, I would say there's probably just a sense of anxiety that I'm feeling in that kind of church opening up again, in the things becoming a bit more normal, not because I don't want them to happen, but because it's like, what's going to be expected of me in these places? What's the kind of, what's it going to look like? What's it going to feel like? It all feels quite unknown again, like it felt quite unknown at the beginning of lockdown. It again feels quite unknown now as to what life's going to look like, and you know, how we're all going to feel. And I think it can be a hard time in articulating how we're doing with it all.
Well, we were saying, weren't we, one of the worst things would be a kind of, and how's lockdown been for you? You know, okay. And we, you know, my observation would be, if we think about a faith position, which is, you know, what we're about, I guess for some people, there would have been no rhythm of gathering. And so maybe it's been really challenging to think about where God has been in this time. Some of us, it may well be, I don't actually want to think about it because that's too painful to think about where God has been because of what I have seen and experienced. And for other people, it may have maybe, you know, I've had a profound spiritual experience during this time, and where do I go with all of that? I mean, for others, it will be, I can't wait to get back into the church building because then I can pray again, and everything in between.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think something for me that's been highlighting is, as much as there's been hard times and stuff that I've really struggled with in lockdown, actually there's been things that I feel like I've gained, or that I've experienced something new that's kind of challenged maybe the way I was living my life. And I feel like God's very in those things, and God's been really prompting those things in me. So, you know, one example maybe is just embracing a more simple life where I'm not just so scheduled with everything I'm doing, and, you know, acknowledging that how I use my time and those sorts of things. And actually, I think as well, the anxiety is partly to do with that, you know, are the things that I've gained in lockdown, how can I retain them? How can I put them in practice? How can I sort of actually, the things that I've learned about myself that I want to carry forward, how do I put those into actions? And these are all just huge questions that I guess we're beginning to grapple with, which can just be really exhausting.
Yeah, I remember there was a program called The Masked Singer, celebrities would come out dressed in these amazing costumes. They would sing and the judging panel had to guess who it was. And one of the judges would always jump up and say, I know exactly who that is. And it strikes me that one tendency might be to say, intellectually, I can work out exactly what's been going on in lockdown. Mm. I can work out what it was about for me. I've got this. But what I love is this idea of sitting with the questions, of sitting with what we don't know, sitting with the mystery, like a gift of unknowing, so that we can wait for God to reveal. And it may well be it's years before we really know.
Yeah.
I was saying earlier, wasn't I, that at the start of this, I heard a lot of people saying, I just can't wait for 2020 to be over. And yet we are actually in a moment of significant history.
Yeah.
This will be a year that will be being talked about for years to come. So having the courage to stop and say, what has this been about? And how am I responding? How am I choosing to respond? What is it, as you said, that I've gained that can be retained? What have I lost that can stay lost? I think one of the things, again, for me, has been, so there's been so many things, but I think one of the things I've gained, particularly with the significant story about all that's happened since George Floyd's death, is the importance of justice and social justice. That's been really revealed that I think there is so much more that church could be.
Yeah,
that is outward looking and looking to speak into issues of justice. So I really want to kind of spend time just seeing what God might want to do with that. Absolutely, to speak into the issues of racism and to speak into our own part in colluding and to examine where privilege is, and to look at our community and say, where are those spaces that the church could be joining in with?
Yeah, and I think absolutely, I think there's been this awareness, that kind of spirit, that way to see how God sees in like justice and injustice in our society, that I'm just like sort of desperate to hold on to and to really want that as well. And I think another gift for me as well is just almost just embracing this slower pace of life, I guess, this life that is more rhythmed and in some ways more in touch with God, because I'm acknowledging him all the time and throughout the day and that sort of thing. And I think that really ties in with what you were saying, of then being able to notice those things of injustice, or notice somebody and their pain. And I think as you were just saying, the role of prayer in this becomes really significant.
Yeah.
Of my tendency is to do exactly what you were saying, is to intellectualize it, try and sort of work it out, get some pop psychology from BuzzFeed, some sociology from Twitter, and then I'm like, right, this is how I feel. But actually, to kind of quite bravely sit with God with those questions and allow the Spirit to kind of direct and prompt. I think is a big challenge for me in that.
I think that I was trying to reflect on scripture that might speak into this, and if prayer is about wanting to be open to listen, then one of the things we know to be true is when God says, the old things have passed away, see, I am doing a new thing. I'm sure that's written down somewhere. As well as, Psalm 139, God, you search me and you know me. So we hold those things, that they are both true. God is doing a new thing. God searches us and knows us deeply. if we were to be able to sit in that space that says, okay, God, then reveal to me, what is it I see that I haven't seen before? What is it I need to be aware of?
I did this last year. It's not very good. It's just to see I'm doing a new thing, something that I painted.
Amen.
And from the Isaiah passage, and I did this last year, and it's up on my study, not because I think I'm a great artist, but because that's just where it is. At the beginning of lockdown, thank you. At the beginning of lockdown, as I often pray here, that kept catching my eye, and that's the kind of message that I felt God give me throughout all of lockdown. So I think it's really amazing that then is, for me, highlighting again is God saying, see, I'm doing a new thing, and behold it.
Yeah.
And that for me, I think, is how I would like to go forward into kind of this lift of restrictions in this way as we approach opening the church again.
Well, it will certainly look like a new thing if people can come into the church building, because there's so few chairs, and I'm hoping that it will be a place that is prayerful, spiritual, sacred. But of course, that we can still continue to find those spaces in our homes. We can still find them in our daily walk. We can still find them in our conversations. But the time will come where we will see each other face to face.
I know.
And where we will be gathering in our buildings. And then we pray before long to gather again to worship. But it's okay that it's not yet, because there's more for us to discover. So I guess my prayer for anybody who's watching is that you might find a space over this coming week to just be still. And whether you would say it's God's presence or just a place of stillness, that you might just allow yourself to be in a place of not knowing. But to invite the question, what have you gained that you would really want to retain? What has been lost that needs to stay lost? And everything in between.
Yeah.
Well, it's been good to see you.
Yeah, so good to chat.
And well, next week it'll be interesting to reflect on how it felt.
Yeah, absolutely.
But in the meantime, blessings to everybody.
Yeah.
Pray that you'll know God's love, and we will see you next week.
Yeah.
Okay. Bye.
Take care, everyone. Bye.